Amina here. So it's been a while since I did a video, but again, it's life. We strive to be better every single day. So today I'm going to talk about a very interesting topic that I really like, and it's like something that I do every single day of my life, and I like to explain some of the benefits on why I do this thing, and why I will want you to join the bandwagon and do it with me. So today it's all about, drum rolls, apple cider vinegar, my BFF. Like, I buy these things, like this is, I take like this is 473 ml, this is for 1 month. So when I buy the big one, it takes me 2 months. So apple cider vinegar, so why do I take apple cider vinegar? What's the benefit? Why I recommend? Like I always say, I'm not a doctor. I'm not a nutritionist. I'm just someone who's lost weight, and I learned a few things on the way that I'd be glad to share with you. So before you start anything or any lifestyle change, please consult your doctor. So let's get to it. What is apple cider vinegar? Apple cider vinegar is, they just take apples plus a bacteria, which is a yeast. And then it ferments over like a month or so. If you want to know how it's being made, if you're that type of person who wants to know, you can just Google. So the main component of the apple cider vinegar is the acetic acid. So after the breakdown of the apples, which has the sugar plus the yeast, it creates the acetic acid, which is the main component to the ACV. The ACV has a pH between 3.3 to 3.5. So it's unlike the other distilled apple cider, vinegars, this is, it has a pH that is 3.3 to 3.5. And then the product or the specific brand that I use, the one that I'll recommend, is Bragg's, because it's unpasteurized, it's gluten-free, it's raw, it's unfiltered, and it contains the mother. I wish I didn't shake it, but in the morning you usually get like a residue which contains the fiber, and it's the mother. This is the most beneficial thing when it comes to the apple cider vinegar. So why does Amina Mude Mohammed take apple cider vinegar? The first reason why I take it is because I usually have digestive I wouldn't say digestive issues, but apple cider vinegar is good to fasten digestion. So what happens? Your stomach needs to have a pH between 1 to 3, so it's very acidic. So when you have a lifestyle that does not promote your tummy to be acidic, you tend to not have the enzymes, or the enzymes that break down specific food groups, especially proteins, are inactive. So when you take apple cider vinegar, you activate the enzymes. So there's total breakdown of food-specific proteins. The other reason why I take it is because apple cider vinegar makes insulin, helps, and this point is very important. I wish I had started with it. So in apple cider vinegar, when you take it, it helps to regulate the blood sugar and makes insulin sensitive. This is the most important reason why if you're on a weight loss journey and you want to take, you should be taking apple cider vinegar. When your insulin is sensitive, whenever you eat, you spike blood glucose, and then insulin has to go up and bring down the blood glucose to a certain level in your bloodstream, and that's the whole process. And then glucose is taken to the liver, and then excess of it is stored as fat. So when you make your blood glucose sensitive and your insulin sensitive, it allows the insulin to take the blood glucose and shove it down the cells so that it can be used down for energy, and the excess is taken to the liver, and if there's too much, they can be stored as fat. So that's like the most important. And when it comes to that process of making insulin sensitive, you also have less cholesterol, which is the bad, not the good. People tend to think cholesterol is bad, but the bad, I'm not sure if it's LDL or HDL. There's one that is not good, the cholesterol. So it helps with cholesterol. And then that, anything to do with weight, you can manage other symptoms like blood pressure, any other lifestyle disease that is associated with being overweight. So another reason why I use apple cider vinegar, and this is like the most mind-blowing thing. So people tend to think when you have acid reflux, because this is something that I've been struggling for a very long time in my life. So I will take like food. I used to get acid reflux because I used to eat like badly and, you know, eating spices. So you can imagine if you have acid reflux, you should take something that will neutralize it, something not acidic, like you run away from acid. But here's the funny thing. When you have acid reflux, what it just means that on the top of your tummy or your stomach has a valve that opens and closes whenever food is in your system. So your tummy has a pH between 1 to 3, like I said, that's very acidic. So when your tummy does not have the right pH, which is it's not acidic, the valve cannot close. So you have something called GERD or acid reflux. So the food comes up. So imagine when you take apple cider vinegar, which is pH is between 3.3 to 3.5, it makes your tummy very acidic. So that, what does that mean? It means that the valve can now close, so there is no acid reflux that come up, and then you don't feel like that acidity. So I don't want to call it acidity, the acid reflux and GERD, what they call GERD. So imagine, it's interesting that you think that when you take like an antacid, it will work. But if you read even the labels, they tell you the side effect of taking an antacid is you'll get acidity, because your tummy needs to maintain the right pH. And on that point, the other reason why I take apple cider vinegar is because when your tummy, you know, I usually say your body is very, like, it's very intelligent. The systems are very intelligent and intact. So when your tummy has the right pH, it sends a signal to the gallbladder to produce bile. So if your tummy does not have the right pH, sort of the signaling does not. So your stomach does not have the right pH, which is acidic, for it to send a signal that come, kujeni bile come. So digestion of the food won't be like fully, especially the proteins. Another thing that it helps to control pathogens. Like there's a condition that called SIBO, small intestine bacteria overgrowth, that sometimes you have overgrowth of bacteria, which is the bad bacteria in the small intestine instead of them being in the large intestine. So that condition, really apple cider vinegar really helps, because it's, you can go into details and read about SIBO, but apple cider vinegar really helps. Another important thing that does, it helps your body to absorb some minerals. The pH, the acidity is like a ground to allow some minerals, and some of the vitamins and minerals, it's like vitamin K, vitamin B12. So yeah, that's some of the reasons why I take. I've just seen one more complete down of protein into building blocks amino acids. So like I said, enzymes that need to activate for the protein, specific food group protein to be digested, are activated. So how do you take the apple cider vinegar? I recommend, Madam Amina Mude Mohammed, that you take 1 tablespoon in the morning before you take anything, and then 1 probably after, like at night or after your second meal. That all depends on your way of life, but that's how I take it. And then, when don't you take apple cider vinegar? When don't I recommend, or when a situation that you shouldn't take apple cider vinegar? When you have ulcers. So you see, when you have an ulcer, it means that you have like a sore or a kidonda in your tummy. So whenever you take apple cider vinegar, you tend to, like, the acidity will corrode and it will make the ulcers worse. So how do you know that apple cider vinegar is good for you, or if you have an ulcer and you don't know? So whenever you take apple cider vinegar, like especially in the morning without any food, and you feel like your symptoms, you feel like sharp pain in your tummy and you feel like you feel sick, just know you have an ulcer. What you can do is just get the ulcer done, like go on a treatment, get the ulcer healed, then you can go back to taking apple cider vinegar. Situation 2, when you have gastritis, which is not it's like an inflammation of the walls. It starts with just an inflammation and then you can get an ulcer. So if you have gastritis, do not try. Treat the condition, then take it. And then there's the other situation, which I can't honestly read, nitawasomeani. If you have a condition called Zoliger Elution Syndrome, this is when you have a tumor around the pancreas, small intestine, that causing increased production of gastric acid, hence causing an ulcer. So there's a condition called Zoliger Elution Syndrome. I don't know about it. I was just doing research on situations because I wouldn't recommend people to do if you have these situations. So those are the situations that you shouldn't be taking apple cider vinegar. But if you're on a weight loss journey and you don't have those conditions, go for it. Take it. Tell me how it goes. Oh, I forgot something. If you're fasting, my friend, and you're just starting out and especially a long fast and you need something to suppress your appetite, this. In fact, why did I do this? I forgot. This is so important. You should be taking apple cider vinegar for appetite suppressant. Try it today. And please, if you use apple cider vinegar and it helps you with appetite suppressant, please comment, say something, what it does for you and the benefits, so that our community or the people I have online can see that it's not just Amina yapping here about its benefits that most people have experienced. So whenever you're doing a long fast or you're fasting and you feel kanjanja, kana chuna chuna, take a tablespoons of apple cider vinegar in water. Do you take it in cold or warm water? I personally take it in cold water because I like to drink it down. I don't usually like to kukunywa pole pole, but if you can handle it, you can do that. Another thing I've forgotten to say, guy nasemanga another thing, is that please take your apple cider vinegar using a straw because it corrodes your enema, which is your teeth, and you'll have issues. So take it with a straw, preferably a glass straw, or you can use a plastic. So thank you for watching. You can get it at Healthy You. You can also get it at Naivas. And it's this one for 473. I usually get it from Naivas or Healthy You, but I don't know why I prefer to get it as in either. You can get it so many other places, but since I go to Capital Center, so I get it at Healthy You or Naivas. So yeah, thank you for watching. Tell me how it goes. Don't buy any other brand. This is the one that I use. Try and get one that has mother. So thank you for watching. Have a lovely day, my people. Thank you for the love and the support. Continue sending me questions and suggestions on what you want me to do. Bye-bye.